2 hours behind schedule, delayed by fog, the Comet 4 brought to Delhi India's eagerly awaited royal visitor. Premier Nehru and a host of prominent people bade warm welcome to the Duke of Edinburgh, who was briefly staying in that great country on the first stages of his round-the-world tour. By Indian custom, Prince Philip was garlanded, first by the mayor of Delhi, Mrs. Asafari. That was only the beginning. Great numbers of schoolchildren and adults pressed forward to follow suit. It was enough for Indians to know that the Duke is the nephew of Earl Mountbatten, their beloved last viceroy, even if he were not also the Queen's husband, to ensure that they would greet him in a fashion, if possible, more than princely. It seemed doubtful at first whether the crowd could be kept out of the pathway of the car, but eventually the Duke and Mr. Nehru succeeded in leaving the airport. The destination was what used to be the Viceroy's house and is now the presidential residence. The insignia of the British Lion is still at the gateway. Indeed, Delhi itself remains in many ways much as it was before India attained independence. The Holy Cow is still indifferent to traffic lights. Minor medical attention is available in the streets. Yet, in a great marquee in the grounds of Delhi University, the 46th Indian Science Congress showed that India is abreast of the times. Here, the Duke represented the British Association.